It is not corona voice that we are dealing with, in the actual sense, it's anti-church virus. At least in two states, Lagos and Ogun. It is now anti-church virus. Clean and clear.
If they are attacking the church, are they attacking the church also in America? Are they attacking the church in England?
The largest Christian gathering on a regular basis in this world is here in this state.
Well, at this point in time, we also need prayer. So I see no reason why a market should be open, why church should be closed.
It's an anti-church global virus, not corona. Tell anybody you see, I say it's an anti-church virus. It's a grand desire of the devil globally to see how they can silence the church.
It's not something that somebody can just open his mouth somewhere and incite people. Especially in a country like ours in Nigeria, people get easily incited, either at the Muslim faith or the Christian faith. It won't be unlike some people now who will hear that and they will troop to the street and say the government is attacking Christian.
But we have a two-way fellowship. No devil can stop
us.
Daily in the temple and from house.
House to house.
Amen. This is not. We are not going to take house to house as your final place.
Now, what are we talking about? The man talking is talking about own philosophy of benefits, advantage, opportunities. If we are talking of churches today to be opened, congregation is meant for Jesus Christ. Teacher, church is your mind as I'm standing here. Art is our church, not a philosophy of somebody else.
Public vehicles are free and they are jammed with people standing outside. This is the only scientific place I've seen where the marketplace is secured against coronavirus and the churches that have well-built toilet facilities. The church where healing takes place all around the world is the one that shut down. The marketplace where they collect diseases is one that's open.
The only thing they can do is that we should give ourselves space in the church. So that if you have space, so that we don't sit near to each other, we can still pray to God. So I will support that we at this particular period, we should be prayerful. And they should not stop Muslims from going to mosque and Christians from going to church.
As at this morning, we have 114 testimonies of coronavirus here. We got 10 this week.
Thank you, Lord.
And that's the place that is vulnerable. You could see the vivid anger against the church.
Ile ijose ti won ti pa fun gba die ni o la koko. Ijoba lase lori eniyan tin be ni abi orun. Ile ba ti ta fun awon ijoba. Be le so pe ka bo fun awon alase. Alase ni won ni akoko ti won. So to ba ni awon fe baye a ma mo fe ni.
Can anybody silence the church? No.
Never.
This is not something anybody should joke with. It's a careless joke that one wouldn't expect from a refired person.
Is there still liberty of worship in Nigeria? Are they operating another constitution that we don't know about? Now freedom of worship is no longer a constitutional right. It's no longer a constitutional right. It's now determined by some individuals. No, there will be no church here. Are we going to war the gate? The doors of church is locked down for life.
Whoa.
We are not going to wait for us to tell us when to go to church.
No.
No.
No. No.
My question is, why is the bishop desperate? What is the bishop desperate for?
Allah.